Hello, this is Teo Sandoval, and I'm here to report a strange phenomenon where children are gyrating, they're shaking their hips in an obscene fashion, which we have never seen before. And we're reporting live this in a scene where a girl over here is exhibiting strange behavior. What's your name, miss?
I'm Camila.
What do you have here, Miss Camila?
I have a hula hoop. It's a new toy they've just released on the market.
Wow. Hula hoop. Strange.
Okay. Alvarado here reporting live on the scene on March 21st, 1963, the day that Alcatraz finally closes due to the deterioration of their facilities. I'm here reporting live on the scene. Excuse me, sir. How does it feel to be leaving Alcatraz?
Leaving Alcatraz? Does that mean I'm free?
Is that allowed? You need to cut it, hold on.
Hey kids, time to start SSP. Sustained Silent Praying Time. 20 minutes every day, we have to pray.
I don't want to pray.
What do you mean you don't want to pray?
I don't want to pray. Why do we have to pray in school? There's a separation of church and state. I'm going to take this to court.
Go to the office, young lady.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good night.
We came here at 6 o'clock in the morning, 5:30 to see them, and all they do is push you farther and farther away, and then they don't even let you see them.
Monica, what are you doing to me?
You know why.
Well, when did he have his last medication? Oh. Well, I have to check with Dr. Hardy. I'll get back to you. Okay.
Dr. Brewer,
that's right.
Oh, Dr. Hardy.
What is it, Phil?
About the coronary in 723, Mr. Gold. He's begging for more sedation.
Is that his charge?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'll see him in a few moments.
All right, thank you, Doctor.
Dr. Brown, Dr. Miller, and Dr. Sullivan. Emergency.
How is she, Jesse?
Still fighting everybody and everything. She wants to live in the dark and never see her face again. That's about what she was doing when I went in. The blinds all drawn, towel over the mirror.
Hi. You know, if you were 8 instead of 18, I'd say, what's the matter, Angie? The cat got your tongue? I told you, your face is going to be all right.
All right. Look it out with the chairs, Dr. Hardy. I just can't take it.
Angie, you listen to me. If you want to go riding with your boyfriend after he's been drinking and there's a smash-up, how can you complain about your face? You're lucky to be alive.
It was a face like I've got.
We'll take care of your face, I promise.
You promise I won't be awful looking for the rest of my life?
The plastic surgeon will do what he can. They perform miracles these days.
Oh, that's what I gotta look forward to. A miracle.
This is a hospital, Angie. We've got real problems here.
I don't care what kind of problems you have. I just don't want to be horrible looking for the rest of my life.
Look, your face will be healed in a few days and we'll take off the bandages. We'll know how we stand after the plastic surgeon's had a look at it.
I don't want anybody to see my face. I don't even want to see it myself. Let's just leave the bandages on it.
Angie, you can't hide behind these bandages forever. You'll have to get used to your face, however it is. Come back into the world again. Live again.
I want to be alive with a face like this. I wish I were dead.
Baby boy, what are you gonna name him?
Johnny.
Beautiful little Johnny. Okay.
Johnny. Honey, I think our son's gonna say his first word.
I'm Captain Jack Sparrow.
Oh, oh. Good Johnny.
Man, I hate the president. He's so handsome. He's so Catholic. And his wife is so beautiful. I'm gonna kill him.
Oh! What did she say? What you say? That you only meant well. Cause you did. What you say?
Nathan Sandvall, and today I'm reporting the first ever lottery ticket numbers in New Hampshire. The numbers are 1, 2, 7, 8, 3, and 4. And the winning numbers are 1, 2, 7, 8, 3, 4.
Oh my god, we won! Oh my god, we won the lottery!
You have to take it or else you're gonna get polio. You gotta take it.
We teach girls to shrink themselves, to make themselves smaller. We say to girls, you can have ambition, but not too much. You should aim to be successful, but not too successful, otherwise you will threaten the man. Because I am female, I'm expected to aspire to marriage. I'm expected to make my life choices, always keeping in mind that marriage is the most important. Now, marriage can be a source of joy and love and mutual support. But why do we teach girls to aspire to marriage and we don't teach boys the same? We raise girls to see each other as competitors, not for jobs or for accomplishments, which I think can be a good thing, but for the attention of men. We teach girls that they cannot be sexual beings in the way that boys are. Feminist, a person who believes in the social, political, and economic equality of the sexes.
Down with feminism! They tell you to burn your bras, kill your children, kill your husbands, sell your children! You see how I'm dressed? Do you want me to dress like this every day, like a man?
That's not what feminism is.
What
it's
is it?
The social and economic equality of both men and women. Do you see how I'm dressed? You could still be a feminist and look like a woman.
What is that?
This is feminine mystique. You should read it sometime.
Women aren't even supposed to read books!
But women can read books. They can have children. They can have husbands. They can do whatever they want.
Wouldn't you rather stay at home and take care of your husband and not have to worry about all this big business around the world and just take your place as a woman in the household, taking care of your kids that you birthed yourself? Instead of running around like a little skank.
Alright. But would you rather follow your dreams and do what your heart desires? Go fly a plane? Go have a head position in a big company? Why do you want to stay at home in a degrading household position serving your husband at all
but
times?
But feminism means that you have the choice to...
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh. When the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure.
So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day, this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama with its vicious racists, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, and every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope, This is a faith that I go back to the South with. Yes. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
Listen, baby.
I can't go much further.
You gotta go on, man. But I'll leave you. It's so cold here on Mount Everest. It's so alone.
Go on without me.
I will. On Mount Everest. I, John Whitaker, have bested Mount Everest. The first American to ever climb Mount Everest.
Yay. I'm so happy.
Hello, I'm live on the scene with Mr. John Whitaker, the first American to climb Mount Everest. How does it feel?
Feels amazing. It's a great honor to be the first American to climb Mount Everest.
How was the terrain?
It was rocky. It was cold. And I lost my best companion, Eric. If you're out there, Eric, I still love you, man.
It's okay.
It gets rough sometimes.
I mean, your welcome back was quite marvelous. Tell us about that.
It was. I was welcomed as a national hero. JFK himself, rest in peace, I pour one out to you. He welcomed me back and gave me a hero's welcome, and I had an entire parade dedicated to me in my hometown.
Well, there we have it. You were always on my mind.
Maybe I didn't hold. All those lonely, lonely times. And I guess I never told you.
His mind, be a mind sticker.
When you can't be with him, be in his mind. Be a mind sticker.
Be a mind sticker.
She's stuck in his mind. She's a mind sticker.
Mind sticker.
Have a shape he can't forget. Tab can help. It's sugar-free. How does it taste? Here's a clue. The Coca-Cola Company makes it, and Tab tastes better than any Diet Cola. Tab is a taste to remember, or a shape he can't forget.
Don't you want to have a good shape? He wants you with a good shape. Why don't you keep your shape in shape? It's great to have a good shape.
Shape with Tab.
Enjoy Tab and keep your shape in shape. Be a mind sticker.
Wasn't me.
Saw me banging on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on camera.
Wasn't me.
She saw the marks on my shoulder.
Wasn't me.
Heard the words that I told her.
Wasn't.
Hello, today we're here with Clarence Gideon. Tell me about your trial.
Well, I was accused of a burglary I didn't commit, and when I went to trial, I couldn't afford a lawyer, so I had to go by myself and stand up for myself.
How did that make you feel?
It's just not fair. You know, the court should issue a lawyer to everyone, even if they can't afford one. It's the right thing to do. I don't understand why I'm here or why I'm being tried for this. I really don't.
Our hearts go out to you. America's heart goes out to you.
Thank you.
W.E.B. Du Bois. Am dying. I moved to Africa because America was no place for my people.
And I followed you.
And now I will die and the land of my ancestors.
Just go whenever. I'm already recording.
Okay. Hello, this is Taylor Sandoval, and I'm reporting. I'm here.
I'm Ari.
Cut it. Cut it. Okay. Every day, 20 minutes, we have to pray.
I don't want to pray.
What do you mean you don't want to pray?
I don't want to pray. Why do we have to pray in school? It's a separation of church.
It's a cruel young lady.
I'm going to take this to court. This isn't fair.
The only thing you're going to take is this job.
Hello, I am Nathan Sandoval, and I am here today reporting the first ever New Hampshire Lottery tickets.
The numbers are...